Hey y'all, it's Costa. I help people break the system to build a better future. Today, we're talking about Medicaid. What is Medicaid? Medicaid is a benefit partnership between the federal government and individual states that finances the care of low-income and certain high-risk populations, including children and families, people with cognitive or physical disabilities, and nursing home residents. Medicaid is the single largest source of health coverage in the United States. Unlike Medicare, which is a federally funded and distributed health insurance available to everyone over 65, regardless of income, Medicaid is a needs-based program funded jointly by the federal and state governments. Public welfare, or as it's known, Medicaid, is the number one line item on pretty much every state's budget. So I want you to think about this, because as we continue talking about coverage and eligibility, it's important to understand why states try to curb offerings and availability. Since this isn't a completely federally funded program, states are trying to make these costs and services as inexpensive as possible for their spending and cover as few individuals as possible. This is why states won't expand Medicaid, even during and after a global pandemic. 12 states, including my home state of Tennessee, didn't expand Medicaid to cover individuals based only on income. What does Medicaid cover? All right, so every state has a different Medicaid program and decides the type, amount, and scope of services within broad federal guidelines for what they will provide. You need to go to Medicaid.gov to look up your specific state and see what plans are available. Federal law requires states to provide certain mandatory benefits and then allows states the choice of covering other optional benefits. Mandatory benefits including inpatient and outpatient hospital services, physician services, lab and x-ray services, and home health services. Optional benefits include prescription drugs, case management, physical therapy, and occupational therapy. Like coverage, eligibility for Medicaid varies from state to state, but there are certain groups of people that are guaranteed coverage. Federal law requires states to cover certain population groups and gives them flexibility to cover others. Now, in my state of Tennessee, recipients must be a legal resident, a U.S. citizen, and within the minimum eligibility of 133% of the federal poverty level, and meet one of the following major eligibility categories, including pregnant women, children under the age of 21, parents or caretaker relatives, individuals with breasts or cervical cancer, medically needy institutionalized individuals such as a nursing home, individuals receiving an SSI check, or someone who has gotten both an SSI check and a Social Security check in the same month at least once since April of 1977. As I said earlier, states aren't making it easy on you to qualify for Medicaid. As someone who's worked in long-term care for the past decade with both our aging population and disabled communities, this is absolutely devastating. If you've watched my videos on Medicare, you know long-term care services are not covered. And if you're over the age of 65 and looking to use Medicaid as a supplement for your coverage, you need to look at the requirements for your state and make a plan. The last thing that you want to do is sign over your house or your savings to the state to receive Medicaid. You haven't worked your entire life to provide for yourself and your family to lose everything now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that this has answered some of your questions on Medicaid and gave you a better idea of the coverage and eligibility. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below.